Hello all, in this video we will see the LALR parsing algorithm. See, the algorithm is named as LALR parsing algorithm because this algorithm is same for SLR, CLR and LALR parsing. The only thing which is different is the parsing table. That is, given a grammar and a string, if you want to do LALR parsing, you just have to use this algorithm and LALR parsing table for that grammar. If you want to do SLR parsing, use this algorithm and SLR parsing table for that grammar. And similarly, if you want to use CLR parsing, use this very same algorithm and CLR parsing table for that grammar. So the algorithm is exactly the same for all the three parsers. Construction of parsing tables have been discussed in the previous videos, so please do refer to those videos if you haven't. So this is the grammar that I am taking for the sake of an example. This is the SLR parsing table for this grammar which we have constructed in one of our previous videos. Now we will see SLR parsing using this algorithm on this for this grammar using this parsing table for the input string $ABB that is you want to check whether this string is semantically correct according to the syntax of that grammar. So we will have a stack for whose initial state will be the 0 here. So 0 is the initial state and that will be on the stack. The start symbol of the stack will be the initial state 0. Now we have this input. Now we have a set of actions that we need to take to complete parsing. See 0. So 0 A. 0 is on the stack and on the input you have A. So 0 A. Check for the row of 0 and column for A. You have S3. S stands for shift. So you have to shift A first. 0 A, A has been shifted. And you also have to shift the state number 3. See, in this table, all the numbers that you are seeing are state numbers except for the suffix of R. Suffix of R are the protection numbers as we have seen in the previous video. Everything else, all the other numbers are state numbers. So shift 3 means you have to also shift the state number 3. Now what is BB dollar here? And again 3B. Check in the row for 3 and column for B. The cell is containing S4. So S stands for shift. And you have to shift 0A3. Now this character B. B is shifted and it is S4. So the state number 4 also need to be shifted. Now it is simply B here. And again 4B. 4B is actually R3. R stands for reduce. And 3 stands for the production number. So reduce by A by B. You know that after R the number coming is the production number, not the state number. So 4B is R3. That is reduced by the third production A gives B. See, what do you have to do when it is the reduce movers? Take 2 into number of symbols on the right hand side of the stack. For example, here we have one symbol on the right hand side of the production ascending. So 2 into 1, 2 symbols should be popped off the stack. Okay, so it will be popping 2 symbols off the stack. That is, these 2 symbols will be popped off the stack. Now you have to push the left hand side onto the stack. So we are pushing A onto the stack. Now this is B dollar. Okay. See, now the next decision that you have to take is you are not checking A with B. That is, I mean, a combination like that is not even present here, isn't it? So there will not be any point of confusion for you. So what you have to do is you have to apply 3A, that is state 3 on go to of A, because for capital letters or non-terminals we just have go to. So 3A is actually 6. So you can add that 6 also to the stack. We are not popping anything, we are adding the 6 also to the stack. So now B dollar here. Okay. So the decision taken is we applied a go to. That's a decision action taken here. So now 6B. 6B is R2. So reduce by. See, you can do these two moves in a single step if you want. Reduce by R2. R2 is the second reduction. A gives AA. So what do you have to do? We have to take 2 into number of symbols of on the right hand side of this tag, that is pop 2 into number of symbols on the right hand side from this tag. So here 2 symbols are on the right hand side, so 2 into 2, 4 symbols have to be popped off this tag. So these 4 symbols will be popped off this tag and register 0 now. Push the left hand side. So now what you have to do is 0A. I'm doing these two steps in a single step. We just did it separately here because that was the first time we were doing this. Now I'm doing it all together. You know that 0A or AB is AB is not present, so you don't have to even think about that. So 0A should be applied. 0A is 2. So A should 0A 2 should be pushed and it is B here and B is rolled up. That is after every reduce move, whenever a reduce move comes, what you have to do is 2 into number of characters on the right hand side should be popped off this tag. Push the left hand side symbol to this tag and the current state on top of the tag should be taken an action with this pop pushed symbol. So 0 was the state on the top of the stack that should be applied on the symbol that has just pushed to the stack 0A, which is 2. Okay, now 2B. 2B is S4. So shift is the action. 0A, 2B. So the action taken as 2. B should be shifted to the stack. And 2B is S4, so 4 also should be pushed. It's now dollar. Now it is $4. Reduced by R3 is the action given. R3 is A, D is B. What do you have to do? 4 is R3. Okay. Reduced by A, D is B, which is the prediction number 3. What do you have to do? 2 into 1 character should be popped off this tag. So 0, A, 2, these two characters were popped. Push the left hand side into this tag 2A. Now action on 2A. 2A action is 5. Now $5 is R1. Reduced by S gives AA. So 2 symbols are on the right hand side. So 4 symbols should be popped off this tag. Left hand side should be pushed to the stack. Now 0S action should be performed. 0S is 1. Okay. Dollar. Now $1. $1 is accept. See, when you get accept, that means the string is accepted. If you end up at a blank cell, that means during parsing at any point, if you end up at a blank cell, that means error. All the blank cells in the parsing table indicate errors. So this is how we do this. That is when 0A gives, symbols saying you do shift, you have to shift the current input symbol onto the stack, and also this state which is following S should also be pushed onto the stack. When you're getting a reduced move, 2 into number of characters on the right hand side should be popped off the stack, the left hand side symbol should be pushed onto the stack, and you have to take the go to action on the state and symbol pushed right now. So this is how we do this. This LR parsing. So this algorithm is same for all the 3 different parsers. Hope you understood. Thank you.